Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And we are now at the Big 12 Championship. Finally, it's here. And I told you, Texas probably has that clear shot to go. And it looks like they did. 8-4, but they're ranked number 12 in the nation. I don't even know how that happened. But what's funny is that our turnover differential went from below 1 to 4. So that's pretty good. So we're number 32 in the nation in turnover differential. But look at Texas. They're number 1. I mean, they forced turnovers. So we did beat them earlier in the season. I believe the score was 48-20. Let me just double check that. Yeah, so it's 48-20. And they're looking for blood. I mean, they're looking for revenge. Alex Brown, what a great season he's been having. 1692. If I get a lot of yards in this game and the next game, I can possibly get him to 2,000 yards in a season. So that's going to be pretty exciting. And look at Ben Miller. I might have my first ever 1,000 yard receiver, and he might be it. I mean, in his junior season, almost getting to 1,000 yards. So that's pretty cool as well. And you know what? Jetter, look at Jetter right now. Jetter's got 8 interceptions on the year. He might be leading the NCAA. And look, he's 1 behind the leader with 9. So Jetter is having a great year. A guy that we didn't even expect to be probably our number 2 corner. We expected Josh Dunbar to be there. But man, Jetter is just like turning heads, surprising the whole nation. But let's look at who is in each conference championship. So if we look at this here, so Alabama is still number 3. They play in the SEC championship. Stanford's still number 2. It looks like they ended up beating Notre Dame. Let's actually look at the final score of that one. 34-31. They barely beat Notre Dame. So now they play Stanford. So if they win, they're in the national championship more than likely. And Florida and Alabama. So Alabama's got to win as well. And then we've got to win. So if we win, we're definitely in. USC, I mean, it's all on the line here. If they lose and Alabama's in, and you never know, both of them could lose. That would be something. And I don't even know who would be in the national championship then. But let's hop into this game, man. Big 12 championship. Let's get it, man, because I'm excited for this game because we need to lay down the hammer on Texas. It was a kind of a blowout last time, 28 points. So let's get into it. Let's go. So as a reminder, Red Johnson is back in the starting lineup after suffering a turf toe. Kept him out a few weeks, but he's back facing Texas. And here he is right off the bat getting in for the sack on that one, Red Johnson. I mean, I've missed his speed so much on the defense, and he's definitely going to make a difference. So on a 39, throwing the ball deep. Look at the Hail Mary already on the first drive, getting it completed, Ellinger to Williams. So on a 2nd and 10, this time throwing to the outside. Wait, look at this glitch. Jim Williams once again with another. Look at him glitching the ball. Look at that glitch. The Heisman cheese is coming after me in this championship game. Look at that. I mean, straight glitch to the ball. That was probably an interception. If they wouldn't have glitched like that, that could have been an interception. But somehow, some way, Texas gets on the board. And you know what? They did it really quickly. Did it within a minute. So they're on the board 7-0. But look at all this time in the pocket. Look at all this time. Look, they're not even blitzing me. They're just letting me sit there. So I find Eddie McCray open past the 50-yard line. So now we got a 1st and 10 at about the 47-yard line. Albert Vick's gonna have a wide open. Jamel Cooley with the one-handed grab across the middle. So now 1st and 10. Once again, finding Sullivan this time, getting in for a rare reception that time for 12 yards. So now facing a 3rd and 8. Albert Vick's not gonna see anybody open, gonna roll out right, but he's gonna get rid of the pass. So we do have to settle for the field goal, and we make this a 7-3 game early. Texas is coming to play. So here is Ellinger back out on his next drive, giving it to Carter, breaking a tackle in the backfield on a 3rd down. We could have had a punt there, but somehow he gets out of that tackle. So here he is giving it to Carter. Look at that glitch. The computer is coming with some glitches. Look at him glitch across the screen. I mean, this is a way to start a championship game.
So facing a third and four this time, trying to roll out. Ellinger's going to get tackled that time by Red Johnson. That speed is just too much to escape. So now we get the ball back on a punt, and this time we're giving it to Alex Brown. And this big game right here can solidify a Heisman Trophy for him. So we're giving the ball to him pretty early. He finds an open hole on a fourth and inches. Got to go for it in the championship game, getting the 20 yards on that carry. So now facing a first and 10, finding Ben Miller, and he's close to 1,000 yards as well. So we're getting him some yards. And here's Alex Brown getting another carry up the middle. So facing a first and 10, a minute and a half almost in this half, in this first quarter left. And we're driving the ball. Consistent throws here by Albert Vick. Remember last game, I mean, he couldn't even hit an open lake with the football. But this game, he's doing pretty well, being accurate with his throws, being on time. And here he is giving the ball to Alex Brown to cap off this drive. And we got ourselves a game. This looks like a back-and-forth game already, because Texas, that was a tough drive all the way down. So here they are back out on offense. Sam Ellinger rolling out and getting a 9-yard carry. So facing another first and 10 onto the second quarter now. Sam Ellinger is going to get swallowed up this time by Ron Sands coming around the edge. So now facing a third and 8, Ellinger's going to give it to Carter, and he's going to just about get stopped before the first down marker. And they actually elect to punt there on a fourth and inches, don't decide to go for it. So now on the ensuing possession, Alex Brown gets the screen pass, one block away from possibly breaking it. He doesn't get around the defender, but not before he gets a 36-yard carry. And Alex Brown getting the handoff up the middle. He's been waiting for this moment. He's been waiting for this Big 12 championship moment, because you know how hungry he's been the last couple games. And he's just been our rock, carrying us all the way. And here he is, capping off the drive with the run to the outside, cutting it back for the 14-yard touchdown run. And this is going to be a 17-7 lead here for Marquette here in the second quarter. So now 4 minutes left in the half, this time giving it to Carter, is Ellinger on that one. So now running another triple option, this time giving it to Williams, and he's been all over the field receiving, running the ball, and that time he gets a first down. So now second and 14, trying to run the ball to the outside, but that man is back. They haven't done their scouting. They've been looking at the past few games, but he hasn't been in, because they've been trying everything. But the one thing that you don't do is try Anthony Jeter, because he's a ball hawk, and that one is going to be 9 interceptions on the year, and that is tied for the lead in the NCAA. So there is no doubt that Jeter is probably going to get All-American, which is pretty good, because we've been looking for a first team All-American corner, and we might have one this year. So now second and 14, Albert Vick gonna throw out to Kevin Oliver, and we are just full of highlight plays in this game. Another one-handed catch by one of our receivers, this time our slot guy Kevin Oliver. So now first and 10 inside about the 40-yard line. Alex Brown getting another carry, and the running lanes have been wide open. Credit to our offensive line. But on third and 3, look at that. Bruh. We hit the wrong button, and we throw to Ben Miller on the opposite side of the field. Luckily, there wasn't a defender in the area to pick that one off, because that would have been disaster. So we go into halftime with a 20-7 lead, and here we go back on the offense. We've been rolling as of late. So now here we are on a second and nine, actually. Throwing the ball to Ben Miller that time on the outside. Nice throw on the run by Albert Vick. So facing another third down, third and 10. This time Jackson Lindahl gets the reception, picks up a block, and he's off to the races. And he gets in for the touchdown, 60 yards down the field. Jackson Lindahl, he looks like he's the future at receiving core. He hasn't had much playing time, but when he does get in, he's been doing really well. But back out on defense, this is turning into a slugfest for our offense, because 27-7, and their defense has not stopped us within the last few drives, but we got to stop them, man. Sam Ellinger back out leading his offense down the field this time, giving it to Pittman on the carry to the outside, breaking a tackle, but our defense is just swarming the running backs this game. So now facing a third and 6 somehow, The receiver, Adam Seals, holds on to that one in traffic, and it moves the chain. So now facing a first and 10 once again, getting the ball to the outside this time to Brewer for the 10-yard reception. And Sam Ellinger's doing a good job of moving the ball down the field. This time giving it to Brewer again, and he breaks a tackle, getting in to the end zone for the touchdown. And that's going to be back to a two-score lead for us. And we got to give the ball to Alex Brown because he's been leading us this whole season. But on a third and three, dropping back this time, finding Ben Miller running over a defender that time, moving the chains. So now a second and four. I mean, Alex Brown, he can't be stopped this game. I mean, his carries have all been 7, 8, 10 yards, 15 yards, whatever it takes. And here's Albert Vick finally making one of those great throws that I know he has in him. It's only his freshman year. He's had a pretty good year. Next year, he's definitely going to need to step up because he hasn't even been hurt this year. And that's the one thing that I love about Albert Vick. He's been able to stay healthy. But speaking of staying healthy, our running back core also very healthy as Jimmy Ward runs in to the end zone for the touchdown. So now we're back up to a three-score lead, and we had to go for two to make it a 21-point lead, and there it is. Jimmy Ward finishing it off once again on the extra point. So now we're up 21. They have about a quarter left as we sack Sam Ellinger, strip the ball, but luckily their lineman is there to pick it up, Javon Pennington, with the sack that time. So facing a third and eight, running a screen pass, picking up a couple blocks, but look at Red Johnson. I mean, this man is an animal, pushing him out of bounds before he gets to the first. So now 21 points. Can we score one more time? Should we sit our starters at this point? Because we got to save it, because we are pretty much locked in at this point to go to the national championship. Because after that hit right there, I'm like, all right, I got to get these boys out. I got to sub these guys out because I can't risk any injuries. So facing a third and six, Caden Joseph finding Schultz that time, but Caden Joseph sets his receiver up for failure, getting hit pretty hard on that one, dropping the ball. So now Texas takes back over. Remember, we subbed our first team offense and defense in, so this is our second team defense in. And here is Sam Ellinger. Look at LaRue Wiley getting straight juked on that one and getting the first down. So we're like, okay, we got to put our first team defense back in because we can't let these guys drive down the field and make this a game. So facing a first and 10, Sam Ellinger is just escaping the pocket, doing things with his legs just by himself. And here he picks up another first down. So now it's another second and 10. This time he's going to throw to the outside and complete the pass to Adam Seals once again. So 4.5 minutes left. Facing a fourth and goal now on the goal line. This time he's going to roll out, but somehow Dylan Mack on the spy just straight misses him. He just like runs to the blocker. I don't know what he's doing. Look at him. Sam Ellinger runs right past him. Look at that. What is he doing? I mean, he just lets him run straight into the end zone. So that hurts us because if we would have stopped him there, we probably would have ran the ball, finished the game, and it would have been done. But now we have a predicament where we had to move the ball. So now they have three timeouts left. Facing a third and 11, Albert Vick's going to roll out right. Look at this. The defensive end is getting in for the sack, and now we have to punt the ball away. So is Texas going to come back within 3.5 minutes of this game? And look at Sam Ellinger rolling out once again. But it seems like when I put a spy on him, he finds an open target. When I don't put a spy on him, he's run the ball. So, I mean, we can't stop this guy. It seems like he's Mr. Fourth Quarter because here he is facing a second and goal. QB sneak this time, a QB draw, and he runs it into the end zone for the touchdown for the 3-yard carry. And Sam Ellinger single-handedly bringing this Texas Longhorns offense back into this game. But we have that man, that bad man, Alex Brown on our side. So we're going to ride him until the game is over. So here we are in a first and 10. This time he's getting an open lane, almost getting a first down, but he's getting to about the 50-yard line. So now 1.5 minutes left in this game. Alex Brown getting a carry one more time, getting about 5 yards on that one, avoiding a big hit that could have been. And we eventually get them to use all their timeouts. So it is official. We are the Big 12 champions. Marquette, what a turnaround it's been. And I mean, what a great season. I wish we would have had the chance to play Iowa State because they had a big season, but we played Texas instead. We whooped up on them twice, And this time, I mean, 7 points. I mean, they came all the way back. So what a victory for us. Red Johnson in his comeback game. I mean, he just is a beast. Picks up right where he left off, and Jetter gets his 9th interception of the season. He is a definite shoe-in All-American. So, man, y'all don't want to miss next episode. Hit subscribe, hit that like button. I mean, unless something just apocalyptic happens, we're in the national championship. But who are we going to face? You don't want to miss it. Stay tuned. Let's go.